Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of God, most gracious, most merciful. All praise is due to God, Lord of the universe. May God's peace and blessings be upon all of his prophets and messengers, including his final and beloved messenger, the seal of the Prophet Muhammad, and his purified household and righteous companions. God states in the Holy Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr, wa ma adraka ma Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alfi shahr. Tanazzalu al-malaikatu war-ruhu fiha bi-idhni rabbihim min kulli amr. Salamun hiya hatta matla'il fajr. God says, truly we sent down the Quran in the night of power. And what shall apprise you of the night of power? The night of power is better than 1,000 months. The angels and the spirit descend in it by the permission of their Lord with every command. Peace it is until the break of dawn. Amanna billah. Sadaqallahu al-aliyyul azim. Let us enliven our hearts and minds in gathering with the remembrance of the Holy Prophet and his purified progeny. Sallu ala Muhammadin wa Ali Muhammad. Allahumma salli. Imagine waking up one morning, and as you look outside your bedroom window, you see that it is pouring outside, pouring heavily. But unlike normal times when it pours rain, this time you notice that it's pouring money outside. It's pouring cash from the sky. Cash is falling from the sky everywhere, pouring. What would you do? Would you sit in your bedroom, stay there and watch? Or would you go running outside? Just like everyone else, the rest of your neighbors and everyone else, running into the street and trying to collect as much cash as possible. It's likely that you're going to run outside with everyone else because it's pouring with cash. It's pouring with money. Tonight, dear friends, it is pouring with God's blessings and mercy. Tonight is a special night, Laylatul Qadr. The whole month of Ramadan is a special time. The Prophet tells us, أَيَّامُهُ أَفْضَلُ الْأَيَّامِ وَلَيَالِهِ أَفْضَلُ الْلَيَالِ. Its days are the best of days, and its nights are the best of nights, and its hours and its moments are the best of times. But especially tonight is even more significant. Is even more special. Tonight is Laylatul Qadr, the night of power or the night of destiny, where the Quran tells us that tonight is the night in which God revealed the Quran upon the Prophet, peace be upon him and his family. It was the night that was chosen for God to reveal the entirety of the Quran upon the heart of our holy Prophet. And the Quran describes this night as better than 1,000 months. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. It is better. It is more significant than 1,000 months. 1,000 months, if you were to transform this into years, it would become a little over 83 years. 1,000 months is a little over 83 years. 83 years is a whole lifetime. It's an entire lifetime It's the average lifespan of any one of us. The Quran tells us that this night, this single night, is more valuable, is more significant, is more important than an entire lifetime. An entire lifetime. 1,000 months. And tonight, dear friends, God has a list of those who will be forgiven. God has a list of those who will be forgiven and those whom He will shower with His mercies and His blessings. And it is our responsibility to guarantee a spot on that list tonight, brothers and sisters. Tonight, we have to guarantee that spot. Because the one, the Prophet, he says, in the month of Ramadan, the one who is at the greatest loss is the one who does not acquire God's mercy and compassion during this month. It's like the one who sits at home and watches his or her neighbors run out into the street and collect all that cash, but he or she just sits at home and watches. They're at a loss. So if we do not attain and we do not acquire God's forgiveness during this month, and especially tonight during Laylatul Qadr, then there is no greater loss. God has chosen us, brothers and sisters. We are blessed. Each and every one of us, those who are observing tonight, Laylatul Qadr, we are blessed by God because God has chosen us. He has given us the tawfiq to observe Laylatul Qadr. He has given us the opportunity to observe this blessed night. And thus, we should take advantage of this great blessing that God has given us. Many of us, we have poor records with God. They're not so great. We've made our fair share of mistakes and errors and wrongdoings and shortcomings. We have a long list of wrongs that we've done. And we have a heart and a soul that needs to be cleansed. It needs to be purified. We have a bad record. It's not very great. God, how many times has God blessed us in our lives, but yet we express ungratefulness? We recite in the dua, خَيْرُكَ إِلَيْنَا نَازِلْ وَشَرُّنَا إِلَيْكَ صَاعِدْ. My Lord, Your blessings always descend upon me. You're always blessing me with favors, with blessings, with gifts, with goodness. But what do I do in return? I am ungrateful. I do poorly. I engage in wrongdoing. I do all of those things that are wrong that I should not be doing. God calls upon us every single day. God invites us, extends that invitation to us to His mercy and His compassion, but we turn away. Don't we recite in Dua al-Iftitah? إِنَّكَ تَدْعُونِي فَأُوَلِّي عَنْكَ. You call me, but I turn my back on you, my Lord. إِنَّكَ تَدْعُونِي فَأُوَلِّي عَنْكَ وَتَتَحَبَّبُ إِلَيَّ وَأَتَبَغَّضُ إِلَيْكَ وَتَتَوَدَّدُ إِلَيَّ فَلَا أَقْبَلُ مِنْكَ. It's as though God is chasing me, running after me, telling me, my servant, my mercy, this is my mercy, my compassion, my forgiveness, my blessings. And I turn my back away and I say, no thanks. I don't want it. I don't need it. But yet, despite this, God's mercy still prevails. إِنَّكَ تَدْعُونِي فَأُوَلِّي عَنْكَ وَتَتَحَبَّبُ إِلَيَّ فَأَتَبَغَّضُ إِلَيْكَ وَتَتَوَدَّدُ إِلَيَّ فَلَا أَقْبَلُ مِنْكَ كَأَنَّ لِيَ التَّطَوُّلَ عَلَيْكَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَمْنَعْكَ ذَٰلِكَ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ لِي وَالْإِحْسَانِ إِلَيْ وَالتَّفَضُّلِ عَلَيَّ بِجُودِكَ كَرَمْ. But despite this behavior, despite my behavior to you, or, oh my Lord, this does not stop you. If you have a friend, right, and that friend, you express kindness to them, you reach out to them all the time, you try to do whatever it is to bring them comfort and goodness, and they keep turning their back on you, they keep repelling you, they keep pushing you away, what happens? At some point you give up, you say, khalas, that's it, it's done. They don't want me, they don't want my goodness, let them go their way, right? You surrender. Sometimes even parents, I've seen parents, they reach a point where at some point where they will leave their children. They say, you know what, my child doesn't want my help, khalas, let them go their way. Let the world teach them. We have limits to our patience. But despite the behavior that we have with our Lord, we read in the dua, this does not stop God from continuing to express mercy and compassion and kindness towards us. ثُمَّ لَمْ يَمْنَعْكَ ذَلِكَ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ لِي وَالْإِحْسَانِ إِلَيْ وَالتَّفَضُّلِ عَلَيَّ بِجُودِكَ وَكَرَمِكَ. God continues to show us mercy. The Quran says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. The verses that our dear brother Haj Samir recited for us. Say, Ya Rasulullah, O Prophet, tell them, tell the people, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِي, my servants, الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. What is israf? Israf is excess. It's excess. The Quran says, كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا. Eat and drink, but do not be wasteful. It's engaging in excessive behavior. Israf is engaging in excessive behavior, extreme behavior. It's extremity, extremism. Those say, Ya Rasulullah, my servants who have been excessive in their wrongdoings upon themselves. الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Here the verse is not talking to a person who might make a small mistake here or there. It's directed to those who have gone above and beyond with their wrongdoings. They have a really bad record with God. الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Tell them what? لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِن رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not despair in God's mercy. Allahu Akbar. لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِن رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not despair in God's mercy. Do not feel that there is no place for you in God's compassion, in God's mercy. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. God forgives all sins and all crimes. God is oft forgiving. Many of the attributes of God, right? We say Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Ghafoor. Sometimes you have attributes such as Ghafoor and Ghaffar. Ghafoor is that one forgives once. Ghaffar is what they call a mubalagha, meaning that God continues to give chances over and over and over again. God continues to display mercy and compassion and forgiveness over and over again. Don't despair. Don't despair in God's mercy. God's mercy is all-encompassing. In another verse, God says, كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ, that God has prescribed upon himself, he has made it mandatory upon himself to be merciful. How beautiful a description the Quran gives us. That God has made it mandatory upon himself to be merciful and to be compassionate. God wants us. The doors of God are always open. It's said in a hadith that one day Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him and upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, that one day he was walking on his way to a private session with God. Musa was Kalimullah. God would speak to him directly. He would often spend time communicating with God. That one day he was on his way, and as he was walking on the side of the road, he saw a man that was sitting who looked like he was in a state of distress. So Prophet Musa, peace be upon him, he looked to him and he said, "Oh man, what's wrong with you? It looks like you're distressed. What's wrong?" The man looked up, he recognized Prophet Musa. He said, "You are Musa, Musa ibn Imran?" Said, "Yes, I am Musa." He said, "You are the Prophet of God?" Said, "Yes, I am the Prophet of God." He told him, "You are able to communicate, you talk to God, you speak with God often?" He said, "Yes, I'm actually on my way right now to speak to God." He told him, "If that's the case, then I want you to deliver a message from me to God. Are you sure? I want you to promise that you will deliver a message from me to God." He said, "Of course. I promise. Tell me." The man told him, "Oh Musa, tell your God that I don't want to have anything to do with him. I don't want God. Let him leave me alone. I don't want to have anything to do with your God." Musa became upset. How is this man speaking in such a way? So he left him and he continued walking. The hadith says that he began his meeting with God. He was speaking to God. God was giving him instructions. He was speaking. And then once everything finished, Musa was getting ready to leave. God told him, "Ya Musa, are you sure our meeting is done?" Musa told him, "I think so, yeah." Told him, "Are you sure there's nothing that you need to tell me? There's no message that you need to give me?" Musa became very ashamed. How is he going to tell God what this man said? Said, "My Lord, yes, there is a message, but I'm very ashamed to say it. I'm very ashamed to tell you." God told him, "Did you not promise that you would deliver this message? You have to fulfill your promise." He said, "Yes, I did. My Lord, as I was walking, there was a man who was distressed, and he told me to tell you that he wants to have nothing to do with you." God replies to Musa, tells him, "Ya Musa, go to my servant and tell him that if he wants nothing to do with me, I have everything to do with him. If he doesn't want me, I want him." Musa alayhi salam, he came back. As he returned, he saw the man was still standing there, sitting there. He turned to him. The man saw him, told him, "Musa, did you deliver my message to your Lord?" He said, "Yes, I did." He said, "What did your Lord say?" He told him, "My Lord said, if you don't want me, I still want you. If you want nothing to do with me, I want everything to do with you." The man heard this and he broke down in tears. This is the mercy and compassion of our Lord, brothers and sisters. I turn away, but God keeps coming after me. God never closes his doors of mercy and compassion towards me. And thus, we need to turn back towards Allah. Today, tonight, is our opportunity. It is our opportunity. If we have been disconnected from God, tonight is an opportunity to reconnect with God. If I feel that my relationship with God isn't as strong as it should be, tonight is the night, and tonight is the opportunity for me to strengthen my relationship, to make it strong once again, to make it firm once again, to reestablish that connection with my Lord and my sustainer, with the most merciful and the most compassionate. And thus tonight, dear friends, we should spend this night in worship. We should spend this night in prayers, in seeking forgiveness, in supplications, in turning towards our Lord. If we truly love God, then we should spend some time connecting with God. The hadith says, God revealed to Dawood, Prophet David, peace be upon him. He told him, Ya Dawood, كَذِبَ مَنْ زَعَمَ أَنَّهُ يُحِبُّنِي وَإِذَا جَنَّ اللَّيْلِ نَامَ عَنِّي. Allahu Akbar. He says, the one, O David, the one who claims that he loves me, this person is insincere if he claims that he loves me, but when the night comes, he falls asleep and he disregards me. And the hadith continues. God tells David, أَلَيْسَ كُلُّ حَبِيبٍ يُحِبُّ الْخَلْوَةَ بِحَبِيبٍ. Very beautiful. Look at these words. God tells David, when you have two lovers, two people who are in love with one another, they desire one another, do they not spend intimate time alone with one another? Of course they do. How can I claim that I love God, but not spend time connecting with my Lord? It's an insincere claim. That I should spend some time connecting with my Lord, strengthening my relationship with my Lord. Especially the latter part of the night. This is why our traditions, they recommend that we spend Laylatul Qadr in worship of God as much as we can. If we're able to extend it all the way until dawn. Because this night is blessed all the way until dawn. This is what the Quran tells. تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالرُّوحُ فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ أَمْرٍ سَلَامٌ هِيَ حَتَّى مَطْلَعِ الْفَجْرِ. It is peace, a time of peace until the break of dawn. And the traditions, they tell us that time, the night time, the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, in a hadith, he describes the best of people, with several descriptions. One is that this person takes care of others, they feed others, they reach out to others, they assist others, they do so and so. One of the descriptions of the best of people, according to the Prophet, peace be upon him and his family, is that he speaks with God when everyone else is asleep. When people are asleep, they're sound asleep, they're resting, this person spends time speaking with their Lord. The hadith says, قَطْرَةٌ مِنَ الدَّمْءِ فِي جَوْفِ اللَّيْلِ تُطْفِئُ بِحَارًا مِنْ غَضَبِ اللَّهِ. One sincere teardrop in the middle of the night, in the darkness of the night, out of what? Out of love for God, in seeking God's compassion and mercy. One single teardrop, according to the hadith, extinguishes oceans of the wrath of God. And thus we are encouraged, dear friends, to spend this time, to connect with God, to do as much as we can, not to overdo it. The religion does not want us to overburden ourselves, but to spend as much as we can of this night, especially in prayer, in istighfar, in seeking forgiveness, in supplication. And one of the best things that we can do, and I'll conclude with this, dear friends, one of the best things that we can do tonight, in addition to the rest of the a'mal that we will be doing, is to perform Salatul Layl, the midnight prayers. The midnight prayers have a special place with God. They have a special place with God. When God talks about those who spend the night in prayer, the Quran tells us about those who spend the night in prayer. It says, فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةَ عَيْنٍ. There are many reports, many hadiths, and in fact, books have been written about the rewards of actions. Many rewards. Like, for instance, they tell you about particular actions. If you pray Salatul Ghufayla, the prayer, the mustahab prayer between Maghrib and Isha, there's a particular reward. If you pray Salatul Jama'ah in congregation versus individually, there's a particular reward. It's mentioned. Particular number, a particular reward. Many actions, most of the actions, they have a particular value to them. But when it comes to Salatul Layl, the midnight prayer, the Quran says, no soul knows the value and the reward of Salatul Layl. It is only with God. Only God knows the reward for the one who stands in prayer in the middle of the night, who performs the Salatul Layl, Namaz al-Shab, this midnight prayer in sincerity and devotion to God. Let us try to do that. If you're capable of doing it tonight, it's very good. The best time is between midnight and Fajr, and the closer that you can get to Fajr time, the better. However, you can do it at any time in the evening, any time that you're able to. And it's very simple, dear friends. I know most of you, you already know this, but as a reminder, just to refresh our memories, how do we perform Salatul Layl? Salatul Layl altogether is 11 rak'ahs, 11 units. The first 8 units are done in 4 sets of 2 rak'ah prayers. So 2, 2, 2, 2. 8 rak'ahs. The intention for this is Nafilatul Layl, Salatul Layl. Okay, that's 8 rak'ahs in 2 units. Then a fifth 2-unit prayer is called Salatul Shaf'. Okay, now this is also prayed like Fajr. The first 4 prayers of 2 units, like Fajr. Okay, like Fajr prayer. Regular 2-unit prayer. The Salatul Shaf, which is the fifth 2-unit prayer, units 9 and 10, like 9 and 10, that is recited also like Fajr prayer, but it's recommended that you recite Suratul Nas after Alhamd in the first rak'ah and Suratul Falaq in the second rak'ah. If you're not able to, you recite any other surah. So this is units 9 and 10, Salatul Shaf, the intention is Salatul Shaf. And the final unit is Salatul Witr. It's a 1 rak'ah prayer. In this, after you do takbir, you recite Suratul Hamd. It's recommended to recite 3 times Suratul Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ, and then Suratul Nas, and then Suratul Falaq, and then you raise your hands for Qunut. And in Qunut, there are many ways to do it. You seek istighfar, astaghfirullah rabbi wa atubu li. You ask for forgiveness, you say al-af, as many times as you can. And you ask God to forgive 40 individuals. 40 individuals, dead, alive, 40 people, and then you ask God to forgive yourself, to forgive you. And you pray to Allah. You ask for Allah, you ask Allah for your hajat, and then you finish, you go into ruku' and sujood and tashahud, and you finish. This is 11 rak'ahs. And you can prolong it, and you can shorten it. If you're not able to do all 11, try to do a shaf and al-witr, the last 3 units. If you can't do that, try to do at least the 1 unit prayer. But do not neglect this responsibility. Do not neglect this opportunity to seek God's forgiveness. If you're able to continue to do that throughout the rest of the year, this is also excellent. This is also excellent. God has reserved a special place and answers the dua and the supplications of those who consistently and conscientiously perform Salatul Layl, the midnight prayer. And of course, tonight, brothers and sisters, do not forget to pray for all who are sick, all who are ill, the mu'mineen, mu'minat, all around the world. A lot of people, family, friends, strangers, others who need our du'as. Let's not forget to pray for them. Let's pray for them first. This is the du'a of the Ahlul Bayt. They teach us that pray for others first and then pray for yourself. Pray for others that Allah brings them relief, comfort, and that Allah answers their prayers. And pray for yourself, pray for your family members, pray for your community. There are many, many recommended acts. Tonight, brothers and sisters, together we will be performing some of them. Inshallah, as soon as I finish, momentarily, we will perform the dua of the Quran. We place the Quran on our heads and we ask God, we beseech God by the place of the Quran and the names of God and the Prophet and the Ahlul Bayt, the infallibles, to forgive us and to answer our prayers. This is dua of the Quran. Then there is a two rak'ah prayer, Salat Laylatul Qadr. Two rak'ah prayer. Just like Fajr, but after Suratul Hamd, seven times Qul Huwallah in each rak'ah. In the first rak'ah, Alhamd, seven times Qul Huwallah. You go down, ruku' sujood, come back up. Again, Alhamd, seven times Qul Huwallah, ruku' sujood, tashahud. After you finish, you do istighfar 70 times, astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. Okay? And then after that, inshallah, we will recite dua al-jawshan al-kabir. There are three recommended chapters of the Quran to recite. Al-ankabut, al-rum, al-dukhan. We will recite those, inshallah. And we will recite dua Abu Hamza al-Thamali, which is also recommended. Very beautiful dua to recite. And after that, of course, inshallah, in between, we will have some breaks if you need to renew your wudu, if you want to drink water and refreshments outside. But inshallah, we will be here as long as we need to be here together so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us, inshallah, this night and accepts our prayers. We ask Allah to accept all of our prayers. Finally, a final reminder that Eid al-Fitr, inshallah, we will have confirmation of when Eid al-Fitr is on Sunday evening. It is very, very likely that it will be on Monday. Very likely. But of course, we will give you the final confirmation. The prayer, Salatul Eid prayer, begins at 8 a.m. sharp, inshallah, here at the center. And Zakatul Fitra is $15 per person. It is wajib upon the breadwinner to pay it on behalf of him or herself and each of their dependents, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah bless you all and accept your prayers. Kindly keep me and my family in your du'as. Of course, you will all be in my du'as, and we pray for all of our brothers and sisters. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.